Good morning to all of you. I heartily welcome you all on behalf of Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics for the international webinar series on decovidizing biotechnology research. This is a webinar series which is going to take place for 5 days from 10th onwards to up to 14th August, that is the Friday. Every day we will be having 2 sessions starting from 10 and up to 1 o'clock, except for the 14th, where one of our resource persons will be joining at 4 p.m. in the evening.
Boy, come on, Panadi, I'll start from there.
This webinar we have arranged from the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics, Kulkarni University, is mainly aimed at taking the limelight away from the COVID-19 related informations. So this particular pandemic arguably has stolen the limelight from all other life science research. So it is evident by, if you go and search in PubMed, the published article, within the 7 months of this year, we have a published literature of somewhere around 34,484 published research. It's already published. So only next to the cancer chemotherapy, that's another keyword if you search in there, it is only 42,000 published literature available in PubMed. So you can see the amount of data that has been generated with the keyword COVID-19. So in the form of either a research paper, published review papers, or at the same time in the preprint, as a preprint also. So this is how different domains have been completely COVIDized. Even you can see the news media also report very, very hardly something about something other than the COVID. Daily headlines starts with the COVID and daily news ends with the COVID. So this particular webinar is mainly aimed at giving the hopes to the MSc graduates who are presently in the final year of their study. So today we are going to inaugurate and we have some wonderful speakers from around the world. So we selected some 9 speakers and they have their expertise from different fields. So they are going to enlighten you about what is happening in their field, and they are going to give you a glimpse of their research. And at the same time, they'll take you the questions. And also you can ask the questions about any career aspects if you want to pursue in that particular field. So please free feel to ask the question either in the YouTube chat box, the live chat box. So your questions will be picked up and it will be asked in the Zoom session. So let us kickstart our webinar series. So let us inaugurate our webinar series with an invocation song.
Sanjaya Deepak Namostuti.
Sanjaya Deepak.
So we have we have invited speakers from different expertise, field of expertise, starting from Dr. Kshitish Acharya, Dr. Bharat, Dr. Sharashchandra, Dr. Darshan, Dr. Manoj Kashyap, and Dr. Prakash S.G., Dr. Krishna Bhaiya Reddy, Dr. Santosh Kumar, and Dr. Atik Khalik. So these are distinguished dignitaries who have excelled in their field, and they are going to deliver their scientific session in the said schedule. So I would really request you to subscribe to the channel of the IWS streaming website, and then push the bell notification icon so that every time the session starts, you will get a notification from the YouTube. So thank you very much for, I extend my hearty welcome, cordial welcome for all these resource persons who have agreed to our request, and they are going to spend their valuable and precious time with us for the next 5 days. I request our honorable chairman and convener of this webinar to welcome the gathering.
Good morning to all, and warm greeting from the Coimbatore University and the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics. The Coimbatore University is one of the growing university of the India. Good morning to all, and warm greeting from the Coimbatore University and the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics. The Coimbatore University is one of the growing university of the India, located at the foothills of the Bhadra Vanya Sanctuary of the Western Ghats. It is the Department of Biotechnology is one of the developing department in the Coimbatore University. Many alumni of the departments are serving in various esteemed international research institutes, and they are contributing for the development of the science. From the Department of Biotechnology, we are organizing an international webinar on decovidizing biotechnology. Friends, presently, most of the due to COVID-19 problems, many of the research is concentrated on the COVID aspects. But many of the researchers conducted good work in various fields of the biotechnology. So in order to enlighten the researchers in this field, we are conducting this international webinar. In this webinar, various scientists from all over the world, they are participating and delivering lectures, and they are enlightening the young researchers. We request our honorable vice chancellor, Professor B.P. Veerudrappa, to deliver the keynote address to this webinar. Professor V.P. Veerudrappa is a well-known social scientist, and he believes in the thoughts of the Bhagavan Buddha, Lord Basavanna, and Baba Sahib Ambedkar. So, on behalf of the Biotechnology Department, I heartily welcome Professor Veerudrappa, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of the Coimbatore University, to deliver the keynote address to this webinar. Another chief guest is an eminent educationist, Professor S.S. Potil, the registrar of the Coimbatore University. He's going to enlighten the researchers and also motivate the young scientists to conduct the international reputed research work. So on behalf of the Biotechnology Department, I heartily welcome Professor S.S. Patil to this international webinar. In this international webinar, many eminent scientists were delivering lectures and enlightening the young researchers in the field of the biotechnology. Also welcome all the resource persons to this international webinar. The important persons of this webinar are the participants. Many participants all over the country and abroad are registered to this international webinar. I heartily welcome all the participants to this international webinar. Once again, I welcome all to this occasion. Thank you. Good morning.
Thank you, sir. This webinar would have not been a success or would have not been arranged without the constant inspiration of our ever enthusiastic young honorable vice chancellor, Professor B.P. Veerbhadrappa, who is a very renowned economist and social scientist. So I request Professor B.P. Veerbhadrappa to kindly deliver his keynote address.
Good morning, very good morning to all of you. I feel extremely happy and really delighted to be a keynote speaker in the international webinar series on decovidizing biotechnology research organized by the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics. I feel extremely happy and I really congratulate the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics, who have selected a very interesting topic for the webinar series on decovidizing biotechnology research from 10th of August to 14th of August. I feel extremely delighted to say that Coimbatore University is an affiliating university established in 1987. Which has a very rich history, which has a rich heritage, being a state university recognized by UGC under 2F and 12B. And the university has been named after a great poet and a Kannada writer, Sri Kuvempu, who has achieved a distinctive academic profile and a cultural identity of its own. Interestingly, the features of its identity seem to have emerged out of the multifaceted personality of Kuvempu, the great doyen of Kannada literature, a Gnanpiti awardee, and one among the most significant cultural figures of modern India. And I am also happy to say that this university is named after the great poet of our region, Sri Kuvempu, who talks about Manujamata, Vishwapata, Sarvodaya, Samanvaya, Purna Drishti, where he talks about the great human values and the great social values of the community. I'm also extremely happy to say that Coimbatore University is situated in Shankaraghatta of Shivamogga district, Karnataka state, and a confluence of the local and the global, as what our Honorable Prime Minister talks about, local and vocal. Here we talk about this university, which has a confluence of the local and the global, of the regional and the pan-Indian, of the sustenance provided by tradition and the dynamism provided by modernity, a deep sense of commitment to the socially and culturally disadvantaged, and an equally deep commitment to excellence. Now, that is what I have seen in many of the Western universities, where they are all committed to academic excellence and they are all par excellence in all academic endeavors, in all economic events. And our university has achieved 73rd rank in NIRF ranking out of 1,000 universities in India, and accredited A grade by NAC, and secured 4 stars in KUSRF ranking, which is a testimony of talented and hardworking human resource, particularly our science departments, who are all doing wonderful work in academics. And they have achieved all these credentials, and are really hats off to all their achievements, and I wish all the best for their future achievements also. The Department of Postgraduate Studies and Research in Biotechnology and Bioinformatics was first established as the Department of PG Studies and Research in Life Science on 1st January 1992 at Bhadra Reservoir Project. During March 1996, it was shifted to the Gnanasahyadri campus at Shankaraghatta. It was later pre-designated as Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics in the year 2000. The highly motivated and hardworking faculty and research scholars have contributed to major thrust of the department: biophytochemistry, bioprospecting medicinal plants. The research is mainly concentrated on the micropropagation, phytochemistry, and pharmacology of medicinal plants, along with in silico approaches in drug designing and drug targeting. In addition, the other areas focused are genomics and proteomics, plant genetic engineering, and agricultural entomology. In this way, I have seen all these people, particularly our teachers, our teaching community, have done wonderful research in various areas, occupying all the fields of the medicinal plants, bioinformatics, and also biotechnology. And they have proved that they are the best in the whole state. They are the best in the whole country. The department faculty have established and published more than 500 research papers in high impact factor journals of international reputation in collaboration with many research institutes, with a total citation of 13,349. But this actually really indicates as to what has been their contribution and how they have excelled in academic excellence, how they have excelled in all their academic performance. The faculty have received research grants from various funding agencies, such as University Grants Commission, New Delhi, Department of Biotechnology, New Delhi, Department of Science and Technology, New Delhi, and Medicinal Plants Board, New Delhi. There are 7 ongoing and 12 completed projects of INR more than 7 crores. Now, this has been a very enormous contribution to the extent of 7 crores. I've seen many departments who have done the research, but this Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics have excelled, have proved that they are the best in the research area, that they have proved that they are the best in the research in academic field. The department has established a center for plant tissue culture, production of banana plants, with a vision to support the small farmers of the region. Now, this is what we really talk about as to how we are committed to society and as to what has been our social commitment, as what Dr. Ambedkar ji talks about, really going for people's values, people's ideas, and people's feelings. And this facility is first of its kind in any traditional universities of Karnataka. So this has been one of our great achievements, that our Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics have been able to go to the common people to look to their various facilities that are to be provided. Hundreds of farmers from weaker sections are getting healthy, disease-free banana plants in subsidized rates. During 2014-15, the Biotechnology Department, in collaboration with other biological science departments, has taken a lead in receiving a major infrastructural builder project of grant of rupees 4.50 crores from Department of Biotechnology, New Delhi, on the thrust area bioprospecting medicinal plants in Western Ghats region. Now, this has been another feather in the cap of the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics, who have been able to have a big project of rupees 4.50 crores. Now, I'll come to the very crux of the international webinar as to why the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics have been able to go ahead with a very interesting topic, with a webinar series on decovidizing biotechnology research 2020. The attention on COVID-19 is certainly warranted. I think the whole world is worried. The whole world is turmoil as to how we have to face this COVID-19 and how we may be able to overcome the problems that are being faced by the humanity. Given its grave human toll and its committed continued potential to kill far more people than it has already victimized. Now, this has been one interesting issue that we have been able to look to 2019 and 2020. I talked about this on many platforms. This is almost equal to the Third World War. People who have died in the First World War, it was about 1.5 crore. And people who died in the Second World War, it was 6.5 crore. I don't know as to how many people will die in the Third World War, this COVID-19, how many people it will take away. Maybe as it has been termed as it is the Third World War, and how the human survival would be a serious challenge for the scientists, a challenge for the social scientists. And even if it does not lead to death, COVID-19 can cause prolonged hospitalization and unbearable strain on the healthcare systems around the world. Now, this has been a social aspect. As I come from the social science background, I really talk about as to what are the expenses that are to be incurred once you really find that this corona enters into the human body. And as to what are the costs that are involved in the hospitalization and the unbearable strain on the healthcare system of the human beings. However, intentionally, the COVIDization of healthcare is taking attention away from other health concerns, many of which are also a matter of life and death. I remember Darwin's theory, the question of survival of death, the question of survival, as to how this COVID-19 has been able to have its own face between the life and death. But how our Honorable Prime Minister is talking about that we can face any type of corona, we can face any type of COVID-19, if we are able to have three sutras. One is the mask, and the other one is the sanitizer, and the third one is the social distance. So he is of the opinion that you are able to face any type of corona, and corona would not be able to have its own impact once if we are able to adhere to these three mantras. And I'm really happy that this webinar, this international webinar, is an initiative. I really congratulate Dr. Krishna and his team, who has taken all the trouble in inviting all the people from all over the world. Now, this is what university has to do. And this is what one is expecting from any university. And I'm really happy that all the people from all over the world are participating in this international webinar. And Dr. Krishna has taken an initiative intended to give a glimpse of the active research going on in the fields other than COVID-19, which are currently not gathering limelight. And this international tends to shed light on career prospects in several fields, including basic and applied research, both in academic and corporate arena. I wish you all the best. I thank you. I thank Dr. Krishna and team, the whole team, for having given me the opportunity to make my presentation as a keynote address. And I wish all the best to all the delegates, to all the team of the Department of Biotechnology and Informatics, and all the delegates, and all the online deliberation will be very interesting and fruitful. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We started this webinar in a very short notice. We took somewhere around 6 days to prepare for this webinar. But when we went with the proposal to our Honorable Registrar, who is a very highly enthusiastic and a constant source of inspiration for us, so he readily agreed to sponsor for this webinar, and he encouraged us like anything. So I invite Dr. S.S. Patil, Professor S.S. Patil, Registrar, UMP University, to deliver his remarks.
Hello, everybody. UMP University, Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics is organizing a webinar series on decovidizing biotechnological research. As we all know, that UMP University is a state-funded university which is functioning successfully for more than 3 decades. And the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics, with a very efficient band of teachers, researchers, is functioning very effectively. And it's a department which is having a lot of collaborative researchers and taking the needs of the society into its confidence and helping the society in large and the field of biotechnology in particular. Today, we all know these are the days of COVID-19, and there's a lot of panic on this pandemic, which has taken so many lives. Every crisis is strong, called to mobilize the entire research community to respond. Especially the COVID-19 pandemic is no exception. Researchers, universities, funding agencies, philanthropists, journals, and journalists have all pivoted en masse on COVID-19. Everyone virtually is COVIDized, and it's a matter of great concern to all. Millions of dollars are being poured into COVID-19 research. Some funding agencies have done this at the cost of canceling or delaying regular and open competitions. Journals are dealing with a deluge of submissions on COVID-19. The media is hardly reporting on any research other than COVID-19. Everything is happening with a sense of urgency, which might come at the cost of careful, deliberate discourse of scholarship. In some ways, the urgency and COVIDization make sense. Research is desperately needed to fight this pandemic that every day is further impacting the economy and costing more lives, disproportionately impacting those living in poverty. Therefore, everyone is doing their best to contribute and move at a rapid pace. At the same time, we are also witnessing a sort of pseudoscience where a flood of dubious and retracted research is pouring in that is certainly far below the normal scientific standards. Bad science combined with poor science communication is eroding public faith in research and is leading policymakers astray. Entire field of research are being lured away from their primary area of expertise to the pandemic response. Scientists working in areas that have nothing to do with COVID-19 are expending a tremendous amount of energy, pivoting their work to the response. This might result in tremendous redundancy and wastage, as shown by the hydrochloroquine fiasco, with over 550 million trials registered on just this drug, and many trials discontinued or struggling to enroll patients. Humanity has endured many crises over centuries. The COVID-19 crisis will also pass. The appeal for sudden influx of funding can be mesmerizing, but is it coming at the expense of their own critical areas of health research? We need a strong-term vision and strategy for scholarship research. Short-term crisis-driven thinking is neither strategic nor sustainable. As a scientific community, we need to acknowledge that all health research cannot be about a pandemic or infectious threat, that all infectious disease research cannot be about COVID-19. Therefore, government funding agencies and individual researchers should be considerate about the risks of COVIDization and should not forget that diversity in research is critical for any society. Diversity in research shall be the prerequisite to prepare ourselves better for the next crisis, which may not be a pandemic. I am happy that the Department of Biotechnology and Bioinformatics has come forward for organizing a webinar series on a theme, Decovidizing Biotechnology Research, which is aiming to deviate the focus from COVID-19 to other areas. The list of speakers chosen for the scientific session and their expertise is a testimony of the intention of the webinar series. I wish all the best for all the organizers and all the participants, and hope that this webinar series will definitely bring we people out of the phobia of this pandemic, COVID-19. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. At the outset, I'd like to extend my heartfelt thanks for Honorable Vice Chancellor for giving us this opportunity to host the webinar, and our chief guest, Professor A.S.S. Patil, Registrar Coimbatore University, for giving permission to host this webinar and also extending the necessary support. I also like to extend my warm gratitude for so many people whom I have consulted for getting the technical aspect about how to host a webinar and how to use Zoom and how to use the streaming facility available in the Zoom, starting from Dr. Pramod, who is an assistant professor in Davangere University, Dr. Santosh, who is also a speaker in this webinar, and Mr. Hemant Kelkar, so who sit with me during in the midnight also, who helped me to go through the testing of the session, and all my faculty members who have constantly, all my faculty colleagues who have constantly encouraged me for hosting this webinar. So at the outset, I'd like to thank all those people who came together to make this webinar possible. So we are going to end our inaugural session right here, and we'll be joining again at 11:30 for the first scientific session, that is by Dr. Kshitish Acharya, who is a faculty scientist at the Institute of Bioinformatics and Applied Biotechnology. Also, he is a founder director for Shodhaka Life Sciences Private Limited, and he is a very distinguished achiever in all the fields, and I have a very high regard to him. And he's going to deliver his talk on molecular basis of gender bias in lung cancer. So kindly take a break, take a coffee break, and please tune into the channel, the link which is given in the website. We'll be right back at 11:30 a.m. Thank you very much.